Okay, Jim. Well, the sunlight doesn't get in there.
60 miles above the moon, the astronauts take in the lunar landscape. Documenting for humanity a radically different world.
By the time of Apollo 8, astronauts had a variety of photographic equipment. Using Hasselblad 70mm cameras like this one, they could take a series of photographs of the lunar surface that geologists and scientists could study in order to learn about the moon, but also to plan for future missions. Hasselblad did things like adding large buttons and dials to be able to allow an astronaut, even with the gloves of a spacesuit, to operate a camera like this.
As the capsule orbits, astronauts try to capture every nuance of the pockmarked landscape.
Apollo 8, Houston, what does the old moon look like from 60 miles, over?
Okay, Houston, the moon is essentially gray. No color. Looks like plaster of Paris. You can see quite a bit of detail. The equator craters are all rounded off. There's quite a few of them. Some of them are newer. Many of them look like, especially the round ones, look like hit by meteorites or projectiles of some sort.
Roger, understand.
On the third orbit, Borman tilts the spacecraft to adjust its trajectory, and a startling object slowly appears above the lunar horizon, taking astronauts by surprise.
Hand me a roll of color, quick.
Oh, man, that's great. Where is it?
Quick. Anything, quick.
Bill Anders is the mission photographer. He begins to shoot.
I just started snapping pictures and changing the f-stop.
Oh, that's a beautiful shot. 250 at F-11.
And fortunately, one of them was chosen by NASA to be the iconic Earthrise picture.
Earthrise is one of the great, most iconic pictures in history.
There weren't political boundaries from space. It really showed that we were all on one planet together.